my research question was, what environmental signals activate root branching in plants? You can come up with a laundry list of lots of different hypotheses that could answer the question of what the key environmental signal is. And some of those environmental signals, of course, we had ruled out already. So one environmental signal was the agar or the gelling agent is what's patterning development. And preliminary data already existed to suggest that that was probably unlikely. But the other hypotheses that we had, such as water availability being the key signal or physical contact of the root with a solid substrate, we didn't have too much preliminary data to rule out one of those over the other. So with a project like mine, where you have a lot of different hypotheses that you want to test, it can be very easy to get overwhelmed a little bit, just because there's so many different tests that you can imagine. How do you prioritize which one you want to do first, right? And for me, it really came down to what was technically feasible, because there were some hypotheses that appeared to be relatively straightforward in terms of how you would go about testing them, and some that would require, you know, fabrication of very complicated setups in order to devise like the perfect experiment to test this particular hypothesis. So with that in mind, I took my list of all these different hypotheses and basically ranked them in terms of how easy it would be to do the experiment. And I did the easiest ones first, and the ones that were more challenging, I saved for later. You could have one hypothesis that is water availability is the key signal that's patterning root development. Once you come up with that hypothesis, what kind of experimental system exists where we can actually manipulate how much water is available around the root? So that was something that I had to come up with. So the experiment that I ultimately executed was something that we dubbed affectionately in the lab the agar sandwich. And this idea came to me pretty surreptitiously. There was a postdoc in the lab that was just troving the literature on root development and stumbled upon this paper that had this really interesting setup where these researchers grew rice roots between two agar gel surfaces. It's basically like a sandwich where you have two agar surfaces on either side, and you have the primary root of the plant sort of growing in the middle between them. And by altering the composition of these two agar surfaces, you can impose chemical gradients across the circumference of the main root. It seemed like a very elegant experimental setup to test what I was trying to test, which was if you alter the water environment around the root, how does it affect root patterning? And the other useful thing about the agar sandwich is that there's kind of an internal control for every sample. So there's one variable that's constant across all the different samples, and that is on one side of the sandwich, you always have the same composition of the media. So you can see in kind of an unperturbed state what is the baseline development of the root in all these different conditions. And if you see that that is consistent, then you can ask, on the other side of the root, how is it responding to whatever my treatment is? How do you change the water availability? So plant cells take up water pretty much by osmosis. So by increasing the concentration of solutes outside of the cell, that makes it harder for that cell to take up water. So if you imagine these two agar surfaces, if one of these media has a higher concentration of solutes, whatever that solute may be, it will be harder for the root to take up water from that side. So all I had to do was add some inert solute to one side of this agar sandwich to change the water availability across the diameter. I had basically two sets of agar sandwiches, two conditions. One where the water availability on the two sides of the root was the same. So I was expecting the number of branches to emerge in either direction to be equal. And then in another condition, I had a water gradient between these two sides of the sandwich. So on one side there was high water availability, and on the other side there was low water availability. And after I put my plants into that setup, I came back a few days later, and what I saw was the side of the sandwich that had this low water availability very strongly suppressed how many root branches emerged toward that side compared to what was occurring in my other condition where the two water availabilities were the same.